walking, is that you? So keep it moving and stop walking. That's right. Into those traveling with small children. Good one.
Robot up here has a name.
In order to keep you safe, I've been programmed to recognize all forms of suspicious human behaviors, including sweating, blinking, talking, laughing, and breathing. And all that is there.
You take a picture.
You'll get there. I promise you. Looking good there. Thanks for stopping by. Good to see you. How are the kids? What a game last night, huh?
I love that you can still tell that that's Patrick Warburton, even though they hire his voice. He has such a distinct voice in the way he speaks. You can still tell that it's him.
Please pay attention to the following safety information. When the automatic doors have opened, please proceed directly across the ramp into the cabin. Continue to move all the way across your aisle, filling in every available seat. Galactic regulations require that all carry-on items be safely stowed beneath your seats. To fasten your restraint, use the yellow strap to pull the belt out from the right side of the seat and snap the belt into the buckle on your left. For your safety, remain seated throughout your flight with your restraints securely fastened. And please watch your children.
Listen, the First Order is rallying its forces. We need your help. A rendezvous with the coordinates I'm transmitting. Good luck.
Otto, I think that the official project.
I'm gonna try out some chocolate popcorn. See how that goes. Even their carts are themed. I guess that's supposed to say Coca-Cola? Anyway, the theming here is so epic, I love it. If you get the Galma garlic puff cheese chips, it comes with a little droid cart. Little popcorn, it's like a popcorn bucket. But instead of popcorn, it has garlic puff cheese chips. I have obtained my chocolate popcorn. Let's see how it goes. Look at that popcorn glistening in the sun. That's good. I like it. It's not too chocolatey, and the saltiness gives it more complex flavor. So I don't know how to pronounce this drink correctly, but you can get it at the Ronto Roasters in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, and it's called Miolu Run Juice, I believe. And with tax, it was $5.92. So the Miolu Run drink has Minute Maid lemonade, pineapple juice, blueberry, cranberry, lemon, and desert pear. So it's quite the concoction. It's got a lot of different things going on. And it's a little tart. It is sweet as well, but it does have some tartness. So cheers. All right, now it's time to try another drink of Star Wars Galaxy Edge. The blue milk. I think that's the one that I hear people liking more, is the blue over the green. You could also get a souvenir sipper if you want. But isn't that kind of fun up there? They have the blue milk and the green milk. They're storing it in those kind of unsanitary looking orb storage hanging things. All right, trying the blue milk. It doesn't really have a description of a flavor or anything like that, so I know that it's rice milk. Let's see.
tasting? What's it taste like, Amanda?
It tastes familiar, but I can't put my finger on it. And my hat, thank you. Like a milky blue raspberry kind of thing, maybe. What does the blue milk taste like?
It's hot. You know what? We were having like those berry tropical Skittles earlier.
Oh yeah.
Kind of like that, but like a little, it's more subdued. It's kind
of
creamy and subtle up front, and then the back end's really fruity.
Cheers.
Cheers.
So the more that I'm drinking this, the more I think it tastes like a, kind of like a blue raspberry pina colada, a virgin one, of course. But it does have like a little bit of a coconut milk hint to it, even though I know it's rice milk, but it's very refreshing. Saber of light.
So there's my, I did the elemental nature one.
Okay.
And I kept going back and forth. I have a big old horn pommel that like is cool in theory. It's more interesting than this, but it looked kind of goofy and awkward. So I ended up going with the simpler one.
Okay.
And a green crystal, which you can't see right now.
And we might get you another color crystal later.
I'm probably going to get another color crystal. I might get a purple one. Or a blue one.
So who has a green lightsaber?
Who's that? A green one? That would be Luke.
So generally people who are on the not dark side.
Yes, it is a good guy color. It's
okay.
The knights.
Gotcha.
There's like the entry level like blue apprentice and the knights get the green, and then like the higher level they go blue again.
Oh, okay.
Or something like that. I'm sure somebody deeper in the lore could be like, well, actually, and like on me on that one, but that's kind of what it is.
Right.
Because like Yoda's got a blue one.
I understand. Well, I know very little, so you can tell me virtually anything. I'll be like, yeah, that's how it is there.
I'm pretty happy with it. It was a pretty cool experience.
Oh, good.
Someday I might do it again and get the, this, I can't remember what they call it, but it's the same style that Luke has in the original trilogy.
All right.
The one he has in Return of the Jedi, so way farther down the line.
Yeah.
Not cheap, but...
No, it's definitely an investment, but it'll look good in your house.
It'll look good, and it makes my inner 8-year-old really, really happy.
Yeah, that's it, honestly. Oh, okay. Not too heavy that you can't wield it.
No, absolutely not. And like most
but
of the weight is
it
all
feels
in
heavy enough to make it feel more realistic too.
Yeah. In fact, when I was building it, I picked not the hill, the emitter, which is like the top part. I picked the heavier one. She was commenting like, that one looks cooler, but it's also really heavy. So some people will go for the smaller one,
yeah.
Which looked nice too, but I like the big bulky.
So how cool do you want to look? Yeah.
Exactly.
What color is yours?
Alright everyone, I'd just like to take a moment of our cruise here to point out some of my favorite plants in the jungle. The Nile River of Africa, the Nile 18th second longest river in the world. It's about 4,000 miles long, and you don't believe me, you're in...
The Nile!
Does anybody know what an aardvark looks like? The hippos have stung 6 of my boats this week, but don't worry, only 5 of them were mine. It should only be dangerous if they're completely missed. That's always different from people. I hit for a shot of this. Hello, I just saved your life. My job is very difficult. Uh-oh. It looks like a shipment of our insects got out. I used to like those butterflies, but they're just not what they used to be. Caterpillars.
Oh man.
Alright everybody, it's time. The moment you've all been waiting for. The amazing, spectacular, eighth wonder of the world is the bad dog of water. Woo! Oh, two, eight. Okay. Over here on the right, we have the front side of rock. I like to point it out because a lot of people take it for granted. We're now entering the Amazon River Basin. You know, my boss, Alberta Falls, once told me that this is a wonderful spot for fishing. A wonderful spot for fishing because if you say the name of a fish, it will appear. Let's try it out with Coronas. Oh boy, okay. You know what? On second thought, maybe that was a bad idea. Let's get out of here. As you can see, Trader Sam has just stepped out for a few minutes to go gather some more inventory. Can you believe that people just leave their shoulders in the middle of the walkway full of stuff? Alright everyone, give yourselves a round of applause. You just survived a world famous jungle cruise!
We accomplished the jungle cruise.
My boat.
Like pros. So I ventured off from my group to get a much needed Starbucks. I only slept about at maximum 2 hours last night because of all of the excitement of going back to Disneyland and just being by myself listening to the music of Main Street, strolling down the middle of the road here and looking at this, the beautiful castle. It's just having a moment with myself. Please excuse me. No, I'm not really crying, but I feel just all warm and fuzzy inside. We're back. We got through it. And no masks. I have to admit, it's been a little interesting feeling having this many people. I'm pretty sure this is at 100% capacity now. There's no spacing, no masks, completely back to normal. They just ask that if you are not wearing a mask, that you are fully vaccinated. And if you aren't, they ask you to please wear a mask still, but you know, that's kind of the honor system, so. But we'll see how that goes. We're pretty much back in action though. I can't believe it. I mean, just look, take a look. What a beautiful sight to see, right? My family's over there at Haunted Mansion. I'm gonna go meet up with them. I don't think I'll be able to get on though, because I got this and it's okay. I just really need the caffeine. It was that necessary.
Water is ready, as you say, to put on the show. Oh, pardon, madame. That reserve is for my good friend, Fritz.
People have got the show rolling.
Wait, wait. We forgot to wake up the Glee Club.
Oh yeah, it's show time.
Welcome to a tropical hideaway. You not these people, you.
And now, senors and senoritas, please place your eyes into the center of the room, that is. We present the enchanted fountain.
Ach, yeah. And the wonderful bird warrior, which has birds on it. It goes round and round.
Look, here come the girls.
Suze, hello, Mimi, Gigi, Vivi,
I wonder what happened to Rosita. Sweet. Let's all warble like nightingales.
Thank you.
running.
Be careful, me fine friends. The gods have been angered by all the celebrating. But me buckles, every cloud has a silver line.
Your outpost number 2 is no longer safe. We have transports waiting to take you to General Organa's secret base on Pokhara.
We're doing it!
Warships! Run! I am Lieutenant Beck. As you heard from Ray, I have been tasked with getting you to Pokhara.
We're prisoners. What are we gonna do?
What I want. Location of the secret base, and I will take it from you.
We are needed on the bridge.
Keep the prisoners here. Right.
You're lucky it didn't spot you. Take those turbolifts and stay out of trouble.
Hey, you're not authorized. Wait.
Operations not seen.
If anyone's back in the blaster, now's a good time.
The escape pods are bored.
What are you going on? I said get out of this bed. Real bad.
I don't think they know that it works here.
The prisoners have escaped.
I'm brave, but ultimately hopeless.
There's nowhere to run.
Recruits, thanks to your hero, location of the resistance base is secure. Bravo! Yes, R5, you too.
What did you think? That was his first time, it was my second.
So, I've seen videos of it online, and the real thing doesn't do it justice. Like, being in those cars, the way they move, it feels way more intense in person than you would expect, I guess, and it's just fun. Yeah, the different stages of it, you're getting the, oh my god, the transport is neat, and then when you walk onto the Star Destroyer, it's so rad. I'm so impressed. It's everything I want it to be. It is one of the coolest rides. It's a Disneyland for sure. Yeah.
Adrenaline rush.
Right, he's gonna do it. You can do it, Darren. I believe in you.
Hang on. Spot. I'm loosening it up. It's good. Here we go.
So we are in the line for Matterhorn. The firework show is about to start in a few minutes, and we're hoping that we can get a good view of a few fireworks while we're going in and out of the Matterhorn Mountain.